Video games allow us to live out scenarios we would never be able to experience in real life. And some even give us complete reign over the entire world, allowing us to do whatever the hell we want without any consequence. What is up, guys? Welcome to Chaos Top 10s. And today, we are going to be counting down the top 10 video games where you can break any law you want to. Kicking off this list at number 10 is Sleeping Dogs. And this is a crime game from 2012 that was developed by United Front and Square Enix. Much like GTA and Saints Row, Sleeping Dogs allowed the player to roam around an open world and pretty much do whatever you want to. But what sets Sleeping Dogs apart from its competitors is its authenticity. That's right, its realness. Looking at the game's world and comparing it to next to real pictures of Hong Kong where it is actually set, you can tell that the developers put a ton of time and effort into making the experience as realistic as possible, transferring from real life over to the video game. And at number 9, I don't think we've ever actually listed this game on any videos on this channel. We have Hulk Ultimate Destruction, and this open world game is based on the Incredible Hulk and is considered by most to be the best Hulk game and considered by some to actually be the best comic book game released at that time. You control, of course, the Mighty Hulk as you roam around the city and wreak havoc to both the environment and to your enemies. While there is a story, let's be honest, nobody really cared about it much. You just want a Hulk smash, and there are a few, if any, other games out there that let you feel the power of the Hulk the way that Ultimate Destruction actually does. It immerses you in becoming the Hulk. Taking the number 8 spot today is Mercenaries 2 World in Flames. This game was released in 2008 and was a follow-up to the first Mercenaries game that was released in 2005. The game followed a group of, you guessed it, mercenaries as they attempt to get revenge and do as much damage to everything out there as possible. The game actually raised quite a bit of controversy upon release as the Venezuelan government was not a fan of you overthrowing their government and actually accused the developers of using the game to rally up the American people for a real-life overthrowing of Hugo Chavez. Definitely not the kind of publicity that any game would want to get. But with that being said, that is a depiction of what you could actually get away with in this game, and that is exactly why it made it on the list. At number 7, we have The Godfather. Loosely based, did you like my Godfather there? That was bad, wasn't it? Loosely based on the films of the same name, The Godfather was an open world game released in 2006 that had you, the player, rising through the ranks of the Corleone crime family and oftentimes finding their story intersecting with that of what went on in the movies, adding some interesting wrinkles to the classic films. Like many open world games, the player can roam around the city as much as they want and do not have to finish the story right away, giving you free rein to drive around and blow away innocent people or go around and build up a reputation as a gangster to intimidate companies and other families so they will actually pay you protection fees. It's actually a pretty fun game. If you haven't played it, I highly recommend checking it out. Now, this number 6 game could make it on multiple lists, and one of those would be one of the most graphic games of all time. We have Manhunt, and it is often cited as one of the most graphic games of all time, but it's also a game where you can pretty much get away with anything. And there's a reason why this game has so much controversy that surrounds it. The executions in this game series are absolutely brutal, and you can seemingly do whatever you want to anyone you come across in this video game universe. As long as they don't kill you first, you can end people's lives with whatever you can find with pretty much no consequence. Hopefully we get a Manhunt 3 sometime soon, or at least in the near future, or at least a remaster of one of the original two games. Come on, that would be awesome. Could you imagine a remaster with today's technology of one of those original games that was created back 10 years ago? That would be pretty cool, and they would probably sell pretty well. The number 5 game, some people would say, a lot of people would say, it's a clone. Saints Row. Grand Theft Auto clone, right? But it does separate itself from the GTA series by adding a layer of humor and wackiness to a world of crime that the player indulges in. Saints Row definitely goes off the rails, you could say it that way, way more than its counterparts like GTA. You can argue forever about which series is better, but GTA definitely doesn't let you wreak havoc with superpowers or smack people with giant dildos, both of which you can do it in Saints Row anytime you want to. And that alone, the giant dildo smacking in an open world multiplayer game, is enough for us to put it on the list. And it's enough for it to garner the number 5 spot. At number 4 is an awesome, awesome series, the Payday series. And you probably guessed that this series would be on here. And a series all about busting into banks and taking anything and everything that you want just belongs on this list. And for a game that's all about breaking the law, Payday actually has gained quite the following for teamwork and coordination that the game heavily demands. Go figure, the most popular entry in the series, Payday 2, has sold over 1.5 million units, not including the Crime Wave Edition, which was released a few years later with improved graphics and DLC expansions. If you want to get into the life, the realistic life of a bank robber, you should definitely check this out. They might as well have called this one Bank Robbing Simulator. At number 3, we have the Mafia series, pretty much the godfather of video games. The Mafia series follows a group of criminals looking to grow their power through the underground crime ring of their respective cities. This sounds familiar, right? It's pretty much the Godfather video game, but way, way better. Or maybe the Godfather video game was just Mafia, only worse. I'll let you guys decide. Whatever it may be, Mafia is definitely one of the most crime-glorifying games out there. I mean, the game is called Mafia. You know exactly what you're getting when you go there, and you knew it was going to make it on this list. At number 2, and don't get mad, don't get angry saying this should have been number 1. I can see the comments now before they even watch the video. GTA better be number 1 on this video. Well, it's number 2. Okay, Grand Theft Auto. Perhaps the most controversial game series of all time. Grand Theft Auto is all about breaking the law. Everybody knows that. Name another game where you can rob a bank, kill some cops, pick up some hookers, go golfing, and steal a jet plane all in one day or one sitting on the game. GTA truly has it all. From the early days of the top-down adventure to the modern days of the revolutionary GTA 5, you probably expected it, like I said, to be at number 1, and it very well could have been. But there is one game that glorifies crime even more than GTA. So what game could possibly be more immersive, more open world, more do whatever you want to with no consequence than GTA? Well, my friends, there is one, and it's called Postal 2. Now, you may or may not have ever seen this game, because this game garnered multiple bans in multiple countries. Widely considered, if not one of the most, maybe the most violent game of all time. This game lets the player do just about anything they want, even more so than GTA, and that is saying a lot. You can set people on fire. You can then pee on them if they're on fire if you wanted to. You can even shove your gun through a cat's butt and use it as your silencer. Can you imagine the team meeting, the developing team coming up with these things and be like, yep, that definitely has to go in the game. Postal 2 seriously has it all. And if you want a game that has no consequence and you can literally just go rain, tear, and hellfire on everything, this is it. It's pretty hard to top all of the crazy stuff that is going on in this game. And to me, it is more than deserving of hitting number 1 on this list over all of these other titles that definitely, definitely let you get away with whatever you want, but Postal 2 takes the cake. And there you have it, my friends, 10 games where you can break any law you want to. So if you don't want to go dabble with the law breaking in real life, and you'd like to stick to the video game universe and just do it in the confines of your own room, definitely check out this list. And there is a playlist below if you guys want to check out any of the other top 10s that are up on the channel. I want to say a big thank you to everybody that has subscribed and supporting this channel. And as always, be sure to let us know where we got it right and where we got it wrong, because everybody has an opinion on these top 10s, and that's part of the fun, is reading your comments and your tweets on what you think was right, what you think was wrong, what should have been up there, so on and so forth. So let us know what videos you would like to see in the future as well, and be sure to turn on notifications. It's really easy, as you guys can see on the screen here. Click the bell whether you're on mobile or desktop, and then click the little box that says, yes, I want to receive a notification whenever Chaos uploads a video or goes live. Thank you for all the support as always, guys. We'll be back tomorrow and every other night with a new video game top 10, and I'll see you later.